This is how to determine the work from reactions or phase changes. How much work is done on or by the gases in each of the following at 1 atmosphere and 298 Kelvin? Part A reads sublimation of 15 grams of CO2. Okay, well, sublimation is CO2 solid going to CO2 gas. So when we figure out delta NG for this, we have 1 mole of gas when we're done, no moles when we start. So that is 1 mole of gas. But that is per 1 mole of CO2 solid. We don't have 1 mole of CO2 solid, we have 15 grams. So we need to scale this. We take our 15 grams of CO2 and we divide by the molar mass, which is 44.01 grams of CO2 in every 1 mole of CO2. And just to be very specific about this, we can mention that it's 1 mole of gas for every 1 mole of CO2 solid. The value comes out to 0.3408 moles of gas. Now we can use our work formula. Work is equal to minus delta NG RT. So minus a 0.3408 moles of gas times 8.314 joules per Kelvin mole times our temperature, which is 298 Kelvin. The temperature cancels out, the moles cancel out, and we are left with a negative 844.3 joules. Three sig figs are going in, so three should come out. And we seem to have an answer blank and web assigned that is in kilojoules. So let's convert this to kilojoules. It is minus 0.844 kilojoules. Okay, there is a minus sign here. So the system has done work. It's lost energy. So we should say that work was done by the gas, because we have a negative sign. Now let's try the next reaction, which is a little bit more tricky. We have 2.5 grams of hydrogen gas and 15.2 grams of nitrogen gas to produce ammonia in the gas phase. Okay, first let's write our reaction. We have three hydrogen gases and a nitrogen gas making 2 moles of ammonia gas. We're given different gram amounts of the reactants, so it's very likely that we might have a limiting reagent to figure out. All right, well, 2.5 grams of hydrogen. And we know that there is 1 mole of hydrogen for every 2.016 grams of hydrogen. So this will give us 1.2400 moles of hydrogen. Now, to figure out limiting reagent, one usually looks at the amount of product that can be made. So there are 3 moles of hydrogen for every 2 moles of ammonia. So this amount of hydrogen gives me 0.8267 moles of ammonia. Now let's look at the nitrogen. We have 15.2 grams of nitrogen. 1 mole of nitrogen is 28.02 grams of nitrogen. Dividing this out, we determine that we have 0.5425 moles of nitrogen. And once again, we'll figure what that is in terms of product. There is 1 mole of nitrogen for every 2 moles of NH3. So multiplying this by 2 gives us 1.0849 moles of NH3. So this is the smaller amount, so it implies that H2 is our limiting reagent. So we should base the amount of gas that forms on or changes based upon the amount of H2. All right, let's figure out delta NG for the reaction as it's written. We have 2 moles of product gas and 4 moles of reactant gas. So delta NG for the reaction written is -2 moles of gas. And that will be every 3 moles of H2. Because for the reaction that's written, where delta NG is -2 moles of gas, the reaction shows 3 moles of H2. Now we can scale this based upon our hydrogen. Delta NG for our specific amounts is based on 1.2400 moles of hydrogen, and there is -2 moles of gas for every 3 moles of hydrogen. So multiplying that out gives us a -0.8267 moles of gas. Whew. So we had to figure out the limiting reagent, and then we had to scale that for the amount of gas for our limiting reagent. Okay, we're finally ready to go with our work formula now. Work is equal to minus delta NG RT. So that would be minus a -0.8267 moles of our gas times 8.314 joules per Kelvin mole, and we are at 298 Kelvin. So once again, our units cancel out, moles of gas and Kelvin, and we determine that we are going to have a change of plus 2048 joules. Once again, we will convert this to kilojoules. So the value is 2.05, I'm going to get this to 3 sig figs, kilojoules, and the value is positive. Okay, this time the value is positive, so the system has gained work. So we should say that it is work done on. That's all there is to it.